The Ubermosh series. What a beautiful series of games. To be honest, I became kind of a fanboy of those games. I'm a kind of a fanboy of Walter Machado. I love almost everything about those games. How it sounds, how it plays, how it looks. Everything. Except for the menus. If you don't watch my videos, here's a small rundown on menu obsession. I expect in your main menu, a play, a quit, an options button. In the options menu, I expect volume settings with master volume, individual sound sliders for music effects and VO, if present. Full screen, borderless, windowed mode and windowed mode are a must, as well as a resolution option, which should influence the window size no matter if a game is sprite-based or not. And yes, I know, most games can be forced into windowed mode with Alt-Enter, but it's the principle that counts. Not that I can do something with an alternative method. So after 7 entries in the Ubermosh series, plus 2 entries in the Triptych Violence, 2 entries in the Swarm Rider series, and 1 very unique game called Warp Zone Drifter, did Walter finally implement a decent menu? No. No. I'm sorry, but this is just impossible. I know game development is difficult and I know it takes time to make these things, but for Melitelli's love, a simple menu with the features I described earlier is all I ask for. If you want to go really crazy, it would make a pre-launcher in which you could set everything up, like resolution and window mode, as well as volume settings and an in-game menu. All I'm asking is for a simple menu which gives me the ability to change certain things to my needs. I understand why Walter is doing this, because he wants to bring up this feeling of arcade, but that doesn't mean I cannot, you know, configure my own game. Okay, rant over. And there are improvements. There's a setup menu in which you can reduce screen shake, turn off controller vibrations, and restart your progress, but that's just not enough. We can also turn off music now, which is a step in the right direction. So yeah, an improvement in general, but like I said, it's not enough. Okay, rant over for this time. Let's move on to the game. The main gameplay is pretty much the same. If you played Ubermosh Volume 5 or 6, imagine those games, but instead of an endless field, imagine being boxed into a small area with forgiving borders. I will not go into detail because gameplay-wise this is Ubermosh. Instead, I'm going to concentrate on the differences. Ubermosh 7 drops almost everything that is connected to the meta game. Class wheel, gone. Tech wheel, gone. Mana strike wheel, gone. Difficulty wheel, gone. Okay, it was a button once, but it's gone. I don't even know if that's a good thing or not, but the whole wheel system has been replaced with characters. Now you have 6 characters. Aya, the clone saint. She's pretty much the blade saint we all know and love from the other games. She feels Ubermosh, she plays Ubermosh, she is Ubermosh. If you want to know how to play her, I linked the Ubermosh part of the Walter Machado collection in the description. Artificer Vuk. This might be my favorite character. He's very interesting. This character has floating guns that shoot automatically in the direction you are aiming in. He can also wield a weapon at the same time, but his most interesting ability is his secondary attack. His secondary attack is like a directional mana strike. It's pretty useful since you can just use the ability all the time and obliterate the enemies in one go. Except for the guys in shields. You can't kill them, because why should you? Wanderer T667. I think this might be the most unique character of the bunch. Wanderer, I assume, is a robot, but I don't really know, so I'm going to refer to it as it. So its second ability is a tentacle strike that instantly kills an enemy that includes enemies with shields. It holds 2 guns at once from the beginning, so the feeling of Volume 5 is well captured here. Blademaster Q. I don't know if this is supposed to be a joke character, to be honest. Here's how you play Blademaster Q. You stand and spam attack. That's it. That's how you play Blademaster Q. Gunner Core. This is my least favorite character. This guy is a weaker version of the Artificer. He doesn't have a second ability, and to counteract his weakness, he can hold 3 guns, plus 2 of his floating guns are pointed backwards. At the same time, this is the most difficult character and most challenging character to play, since you have to learn how to dodge shots and how to move around the arena. So it's kind of difficult to tell because I like the challenge and at the same time I just don't like the character. Saika Reese, she's pretty strong. To be honest, I just don't connect with her playstyle. She's a mix of the Blade Saint from Volley 1 plus a little bit of Artificer. Instead of using the blade to deflect bullets, she has a staff, which is pretty cute. I like this little touch to her character. She can only hold one gun, which is pretty weak, but I think her strength comes from the powerful Mana Strike, which destroys everything around her at max level. And with this beautiful transition, let's talk about Ascension levels. Yeah, so in the last 6 games, we had a bunch of goals that you had to work towards. In Volume 7, we have Ascension levels. Here it's how it works. Every character starts at a different ascension level, representing their initial strength. For example, the Artificer begins at 80%, meaning there isn't much to increase. He's already a strong character. To reach the next level of ascension, we have to reach a certain amount of points. In the case of the Artificer, it will increase by 1% per score goal reached, meaning you have to play at least 20 rounds to get to 100%. The crazy thing is that every character needs at least 20 runs, but because Aya increases 5% per score, she feels much faster to max out than Artificer, even though there is absolutely no difference. Reaching 100% awards you with an achievement and access to your high score. Yep, that's it. Remember the lore video I made because I couldn't find anything conclusive? Well, turns out I was wrong. Walter corrected my story, so now I have an actual story I can build the new video on, if I feel like it. I was expecting something to happen at 100% ascension level, a text card, a small video, a voiceover, anything, anything at all. This series has been going on for 7 games now, and all we got is the announcer that says a few lines in the tutorial section of the old games, and now even that is gone. I don't understand, really. Why is my story, bro? Where's my story? A voiceover line. That's all I ask for. Okay, second rant over. Would I recommend the game? If someone wants to jump into the Ubermosh universe fresh, then yes, buy this one. This is the best game of the series. With my heart broken for everyone that played other Ubermosh titles and are happy with the games, it's a disappointing no. This game was in early access, so Walter deserves some acknowledgement for that. Walter delivered everything that he promised to deliver. The gameplay, the music, and the looks are, as always, amazing. Menus and the story are simply missing, and I think that drags the game down for me, and I think for other veterans as well. There are no new enemies, no new weapons in itself. The character adds, of course, a lot of value to the game, and I think everyone is going to have their favorite character, but it's not enough. Simply not enough. The only way forward for Ubermosh that I see right now is either going 3D or adding a bunch of stuff like bosses or different kinds of modes to the Ubermosh gameplay, and of course, adding a really damn story. But I want to know what you think. You know, what do Ubermosh veterans think of Volume 7? I'm kind of disappointed to a certain extent. I can't even put it in words correctly. You know, it's not the disappointment. This is really a real disappointment. I just feel personally disappointed because I wish some of the things that we have been talking about, like the menu or the story, have been implemented in this version. You know, because it's a bigger version, you know. I don't know. I don't know if it's personal or just me being too critical, too skeptical, this pretentious critic thing, you know. Whatever. It's a good game, but I can't really recommend this to everyone, especially not to Ubermosh veterans, even though this might be the best one of the Ubermosh series. Anyways, let me know what you think about Ubermosh Volume 7 in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and don't forget to subscribe. Turn on notifications, you know the drill. Yeah, maybe consider sharing the video as well, you know, that would be cool. Take care of yourselves and have a nice and wonderful day.